Okay, so let's look at each of the functions that you need to know for grade 10. These will be the same functions that you do in matric. The only slight difference is that in matric, with your hyperbola functions, you will be doing two asymptotes, whereas in grade 10, you only have to know the one. Okay, so the first one you will remember from grade 8 and 9 is just your regular straight line function, right? So the straight line function could be, say, go th straight through the middle, and this would be y equals x. And you could plot that using a table. You couldn't plot
Right.
using a intercept method because if you were to try and plot y equals x using the intercept method, you'd get the intercept of y equals 0 and x equals 0 in the middle, right, the origin. But the problem with that is then if you put the both intercepts there, how would you draw the line if you didn't know that it went like this? But you don't have two points to join. Whereas if you get, say, something like y equals x plus 1, so let's say you got y equals x plus 1. If you were to
Well,
plot,
then you can,
yeah.
where x would be 1, y would be 2,
Correct.
because it would be x plus 1. Yeah.
Yeah. Well, to get your y-intercept, you would make x equals 0. And so you would get y equals 1. Right? Because it would be 0 for the x plus 1. So you just get y equals 1. Well, that would be up here, right? Somewhere around here, like 1. Now
Yeah.
to get your x-intercept, you would make y equals 0, right? And so you would get y equals well, you make your y 0, right? So you make 0 equals x plus 1. Take the one across, you get minus 1.
Then x equals minus 1, yeah.
Over here. Okay, so notice that it shifts it up by 1.
Right.
Shifts it up by 1. So there's your graph of y equals x plus 1. I can label that. Now, what happens with it in terms of the x? It goes to minus 1, it goes backwards, right? So it goes
Yes.
up by 1, but it goes backwards.
Backwards. Yeah.
Okay, and this is something to bear in mind. Now, if you think of it in terms of y, it's intuitive because if y changes, it goes up by 1 in terms of the y. But in terms of the x, it goes backwards. And that's because this 1, when it goes to the other side, becomes minus 1. Okay, so bear this in mind when you're looking at functions, is that if you add something on the right-hand side, like plus 1, it'll go upwards. But also in terms of the x, it goes backwards. Okay, so in terms of x, it's counterintuitive. And that's because x and 1 are on the same side. So when the 1 goes across, it becomes minus 1. And that's why you get a backwards shift. So in terms of the vertical, it's up, but in terms of the horizontal, it's backwards, so it's counterintuitive. Okay,
Right.
so you'll be asked maybe to plot a straight line function using the intercept method. And you can do it as long as it's not y equals x, which just goes straight through. Right? Now, it could also change, the gradient could also change. Right? So I could have, say, y equals 2x. Okay, and 2 is the steepness. Right? Steepness. So this is twice as steep. So when x is 1, y would be 2. So it might be up here somewhere where x is 1. And
right.
It still goes through the origin. So it would look something like this. It would be much steeper. So
okay.
Y equals 2x. Okay, so when you look at your straight line graph, you get this general formula, right? Mx plus c. So m is the steepness, the slope. And the c is that y-intercept, right?
Yeah.
So if I was,
and
if I was to combine this, so this was the y equals 2x. Now, if I was to combine this like this, 2x plus, say, 2, now you have a y-intercept of 2. Right, this one. But your steepness is still 2, so it's twice as steep. So if we were to get the y-intercept,
yeah,
we would make x equal to 0. And we would get y equals 2 from 0, which is 0, so 2, right?
Yeah.
Your x-intercept.
Y equals 0.
Right. So you say 0 equals 2x plus 2. 2 goes across and becomes minus 2.
So x equals 1.
Minus 1, right?
Minus 1, sorry, yeah.
So that would be over here. Okay, so
it would be connecting to, well,
it would be, I'm going to do it in, let's do a different color. I'm doing it in orange. And so we connect these two lines here. Now it should be the same steepness as the red one because it's got the same 2. So that was y equals 2x. And so it should just be like that.
Right. So yeah. Would that be parallel to the other one or not?
The red one.
No, it isn't.
It is parallel. It looks like it's not because I haven't drawn it too accurately, but it should be parallel because it's got the same number in front of the x, but the same m.
Is that the gradient? Yeah, same gradient.
So that's the y equals 2x plus 2 with the same gradient and the y-intercept being 2. And then the x-intercept being minus 1, which we calculated.
Right.
Okay, so we've got our straight line function. If you add a value here plus this number by itself, that's your y-intercept. And then your number in front of the x is your steepness or your slope. Okay, so notice that because it's plus 2 again, how it changed from your regular, this y equals x, it went backwards again.
Right.
But it went up because of the plus two. So the plus two shifts it up by two, and it shifted it backwards only by one, and that's because of the two in front of the x. Right, so when we solved it, we got x equals negative one, right? So it was a minus one shift from the origin.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, any questions on the straight line functions?
Not really, but there's some of the questions that can get a bit confusing.
Yeah, so we'll do questions after this. Okay, so
Okay.
the C is the y-intercept and the M is the slope. Okay, and of course, yes, the questions do get, as long as you understand this is the basics, and then when we do questions, we'll just see how to apply. Okay, so the main
Okay.
thing is to know that if you have a positive number in front of the x, as these are all sloping upwards, right?
Right.
If you had a negative x, so y equals negative x.
That'd be wouldn't it would be going the other way,
Will
like
be sloping downwards.
yeah, downwards, positive, negative to positive
So we'll go like that.
in terms of X, yeah.
Okay, because it's like you're running down the hill. You're not up the hill. That's a negative. Okay, now your parabola. So your parabola is when you get a x squared. Instead of your y equals x, you've got an x squared. Now your general format for your parabola is y equals something x squared. Oh, now I think in grade 10, you only have plus two. You don't have like a 2x or a 3x. It'll just be a plus two or a minus one. You won't see something like this, right? 2x.
It just says like the equation is y equals ax squared plus q.
Yes. So at this stage, in matric, you will be doing two intercepts. For now, you only have one. So with these functions, you always want to know the what the regular one looks like. So this is the y equals x squared I'm going to draw. Let me actually draw this in.
Mean, I know it's like a smiley face, and then the negative is upside down.
Good. So this is your smiley face. Parabola. Because of the plus. There's a plus in front of this x squared, right? So this is your y equals x squared graph. Now, if we were to say minus one, this would bring it down by one. And so this would be y equals x squared minus one.
That's the y-intercept.
Yes. Because you see, here's a zero here. There's a technically there's a zero here. We don't see it, but there's a plus
Connects to the
zero.
origin.
So,
So then it goes to the origin. Yeah.
minus one shifts it down by one. And then, as you rightfully said, this is a smiley face. Let's look at a sad face. So this would be y equals negative x squared. And of course, that's going to be unhappy. Now, if I said y equals negative x squared plus one, that shifts that sad face up by one.
Right.
That could be. Intercept at one. Y intercept would be one. Okay, now let's say that you wanted to now plot one of these, right? So we can see what the general format looks like, but let's say we had to plot one. So let's say you were given y equals x squared minus four. So again, just like our straight line, our y-intercept, we make x equals 0. So we find our y-intercept. Right. So y equals 0 squared minus 4 is y equals minus 4.
Right.
And our x intercept.
Y equals 0.
Good. We get 0 equals x squared minus 4. Now notice that the 4, let's take the 4 across to the other side.
And x. Positive 4.
Yeah. X squared. Now we find the square root.
Now this is 2.
This is 2. But now you don't want to say just plus or minus. You don't want to just say 2. It's plus or minus 2.
Okay.
Because what's minus 2 times minus 2?
4.
Cool. So you would also get to 4 if it was minus 2, because it would be minus 2 times minus 2 would be 4. And of course, that makes sense because look at these. They've all got two x-intercepts. Okay.
Yeah.
So
I never thought about it like that. I just thought that it was just what you wrote as the answer.
So we'll do this one in orange. And now if we were to plot this, the y-intercept would be sort of negative 4 around here. And then our x intercepts will be 2. So say over here, 2. And over here, say minus 2. 2 and minus 2. And it's plus, so it's a happy face in front of the x squared. So it could be happy face like that. Okay, so that would be our y equals x squared minus 4. Now, if you get an x squared plus 4, you would not get any, because imagine that this was plus 4, this minus 4. So say, let's just say that I've moved this up by 4, right?
Right.
Okay. We notice that it doesn't have any x intercepts. So
right.
If it was x squared plus 4, you'd have to plot using a table because you actually wouldn't have any x intercepts to connect the graph with.
Would I get a question like that where there wouldn't
probably
be any?
Probably not. But that's just to let you know why that would be a tricky one.
All right.
Okay. In this, so if you had an x squared plus 4, it wouldn't work. And let me just show you the math behind why it wouldn't work to get your x-intercept. So let's say I have y equals x squared plus 4. And I had to solve for the x's and make y equal 0 in order to get my x-intercept. So this goes across and becomes minus 4. So I get x squared equals negative 4. Well, when you have x squared, if it's negative 2, let's say, negative 2 times negative 2 gives me 4, right? I can't get to minus 4. If I have 2s, 2 times 2 is 4, I get to 4. I never get to negative 4 if I have an x squared. I can never get there. And that's why we have the scenario where we don't have any x-intercepts. Because if it goes all the way up here and you can't figure anyone out. So that's when we do AP maths, we do imaginary roots and imaginary numbers, and we are able to find the roots using imaginary numbers. But don't worry about that. That's just for AP maths.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, so that's the parabola. Any questions about the parabola?
Not really. It's just when finding I had it here.
I'm just going to pause the video.
How do you find the equation? Like when it would show you.
When you're given something, when you're given
when you're given like one of the points, like.
Okay. Good question. Okay. So let's Let's say that we are given this and this. And let's say we're given that this is minus 9, and then this is minus 3 and plus 3.
Right.
Okay, well, we know that it's something x squared.
Yeah.
And then it's a smiley face, so it's, we know it's going to be positive. Now, of course, we know our y-intercept is minus 9, so we know that that's going to be minus 9. Okay.
Okay.
Now, there could be a number in front of this x squared. So we could have an m here, right? So how would I get this m? Okay, because it's not always going to be, it could be 2x squared or 3x squared. So what I do to get our m is I've got our minus 9, which I've put in as our y-intercept. But I've also got a point on here, right? This point where there's a 3 is actually the point 0 and 3, right? Because our y is 0. So this is the point 0 and 3. Now my right. 0 is the y, is the x value. Sorry, it's 3 and 0. Beg your pardon. My x is 3 and my y at that point is 0. It's origin.
Right.
So I can put the 0 over here for my y, because I know that the y is 0. My m is what I'm trying to figure out. And my x is the 3. So that'll be 3 squared minus 9. So my 9 goes to the other side and becomes plus 9, right?
Yeah.
And m, and then what's 3 squared?
Wait, may I please say it again? I didn't hear you.
3 squared is 3 squared, 3 times 3.
Right.
Is 9, right?
Yes.
So it'll be m times 9. So 9 equals m times 9, or 9m. So m must be 1, right? Because 1 times 9 will be 9.
Yes.
So
okay, I see.
So in this situation, my m is 1. So it's just y equals
x squared minus 9.
Minus 9. Right? But I could get a different value over here, right? I could have this as let's say that these values were 2. Two and minus two. Well, then my points, this point here would be 2 and 0, right? And so instead of putting two, I put three, I put two. And that'll be 2 squared, which is 4. And so m to get, so I basically have 9 equals m times 4, which is the same as saying 4m. And if I was
right.
to get m by itself, I would divide both sides by 4. And I get m equals 9 over 4. Okay. And so that function would be y equals 9 over 4 x squared minus 9. Okay. So
yeah,
we get our y-intercept, gives us our value over here. Is 9, and then our m we figure out by substituting in one of the points. Now, they don't necessarily need to give me this point 2 and 0. They could give me a point over here, right? They could give me this point here, say it was 3 and 7. And then we would use these as our x and our y values in order to find out what m is.
Right.
Okay, so in a nutshell, our general format for a parabola is y equals, or say
m.
This could be a. Sometimes they call it a, but it doesn't matter.
Okay.
We'll say mx squared. It could be ax squared. In fact, I'm going to call it a. I call it
okay, because that's what is written here as well. Yeah.
Yes, it should be called A because when you get to matric, it'll be ax squared plus bx plus c. So what have you got? Ax squared plus, do you have plus c or plus q?
I've got plus Q.
Okay, that's fine. All right, so q we know is our y-intercept, and a
That's
we
good.
figure out because we
Is
need
the
to get to
gradient.
one point, and then that one point we will use as our y and our x, and as well as our q, in order to figure out the formula for the parabola. Okay,
Yeah.
let's look at the hyperbola next. Okay. So the general format for the hyperbola is y equals, we'll say a. Do you have a over x plus q? I imagine would be what they've given So I'm just going to give the function of y equals, say, 2 over x. So the way this normally looks, so your standard sort of equation of y equals something over x, so like a 2 over x, that looks like this.
Yeah.
Now the two.
Is a positive one.
Yes, this is the positive one. Good. So that's y equals 2 over x. Okay, and these have two what we call asymptotes. You've got an asymptote here, which is y equals 0. And you've got an asymptote here, and let's do this a different color, which is x equals 0. Now, in grade 10, your asymptote changes only up and down for now. So you'll always have an asymptote in grade 10 of x equals 0, but this y equals 0 can change. And that depends on Q.